Hello there, my music lovers. I'm Josh Mediafile Heaven, and today we are having a look at Etymotic E3 SE. This is pretty much the cheapest monitor you can actually get your hands on, and this is an actual proper in-ear monitor. So let's find out why I didn't like the older Etymotic models and why I actually like them quite a bit right now. The unboxing of the E3 SE is actually quite interesting. It is not a very complex EM, and it comes packaged way less interesting than the other ones. I actually did the full written review already, so I did not really have the time to repack it for the video. But anyways, with it we get some foam tips, one extra pair of triple flange tips, cleaning tool, shirt clip, multiple B flange tips. I guess the company noticed that the triple flange tips are not very comfortable in reality. Some paperwork, actually, I'm not even going to bother. We do get a nice carrying case, soft in nature, but pretty good to keep the EMs in. Won't offer them a lot of protection, I'll be honest with you. And here are the EMs. They look so plasticky and cheap, actually. Those do not look very expensive. And even their most expensive model, the E4 XR, does not look very expensive. They all look a bit cheap. But that is the point. They should not look very expensive. They shouldn't be too fancy. Those are in-ear monitors. They are meant for monitoring and they should disappear in your ear. For example, this is something that a Romanian music producer told me. When wearing a monitor, you want it to disappear. You don't want anyone to know that you're wearing a monitor. You want it to be your secret. Like, that is going to be an intimate thing. So the fact that they don't impose themselves is actually good. Their cable is actually good in terms of survivability. I actually had this cable survive for me for years. So despite it looking quite frail, being very simple cable, this is one of the cheapest looking cables I know, it actually survives. So you should not be too worried about the E3 SE. The EMs are some of the most disparaging EMs in the entire world, because either you actually are okay with the comfort and you get a beautiful sound, or you dislike the comfort, you never get a good seal with them, and then you get a terrible sound from them. Because if they don't seal your ear canal perfectly, you don't get any bass from them. And that basically makes you think that they are very fatiguing, very boring, and not worth their asking price. Happily for me, I was able to actually get them in tune, to get them to sound good. And in the end, I was able to get a beautiful sound from them. But here's the thing. Their build quality is okay. Nothing special, nothing bad, nothing terrible. It is okay. But once you insert them, you basically need to keep in mind first that they need to be inserted straight down. They prefer that type of insertion. Inserting them straight down results in some microphonic noise. So you can hear, if you're touching the cables, you can hear this type of noise. You can hear it rubbing against your skin. You can hear the cables rubbing against each other, and that is quite inconvenient. So you may end up wearing them over the ear. The tips also get dirty very easily compared to other tips, because they are inserted so deeply inside your ear and you need to clean them more often than your typical EM. You may also get an infection from wearing them if you are not careful and if you damage your ear canal. Inserting them means inserting them right up to your brain, and you can totally feel that they are inside. The first insertion part is actually the most uncomfortable part, because once they are in, they kind of settle in and your ear kind of get used to it. But before getting used to them, they are very invasive to your ears. You know that you're wearing them, you know that you have something inside, and you kind of want to take them out at first. After getting used to them, they offer a good amount of passive noise isolation, but they are not the best. For example, right now I'm having about 20 to 25 decibels of passive noise isolation, but I had the luck to be next to my girlfriend sitting at the computer, and I was wearing the E3 SE and making switches between them and the Unique Melody Mest 2. Just happened that was the model. And when doing the switch, I actually noticed this. The Mest 2 offers way more passive noise isolation. They leak less than the E3 SE, and they're actually better as a performing EM. So paying more for an EM is going to get you a better performance. Don't worry about that. Don't worry when you see something that is a bit expensive. Don't worry. They tend to have a reason for being expensive, and companies don't really make expensive and bad products. I'm not saying that everything expensive is good, and I'm not saying that you should always go for the price. But when producing something expensive, companies tend to keep in mind what people want, and they tend to make something good. That was a fear of mine that I was at some point going to purchase something very expensive that was not going to work very well, but so far that experience did not come true. So I hope you are as lucky as I have been. Above and beyond all of the inconveniences of wearing the Air A3 SA, they are pretty hard to power. They consume way more power from my portables than any other EM. They are not drivable from my smartphone. They need a DAP or a DAX dash headphone amplifier, at least something portable like the Shanling U A2 or Yerman Sparrow or Fio BTR5 or Ibeiso DC Dacam series or Audirect Beam. They need something. They need something to sound good. And that is something to keep in mind. They are made to be used with something a bit more professional, not a smartphone. The sound is actually excellent. I'm in love with the sound of Air A3 SA. I actually did not like their original models as much because only now I realized that I was not getting a full seal with their original model. So only now I'm getting the full seal with them, with Air A3 SA. It is the first time when I'm reviewing Etymotic and I'm actually doing the whole put it inside your brain thing, where you actually get to that sound that everyone is so excited about. So this is the SR series, this is not the XR series. So basically this is the series that has the most natural type of sound, and I can hear that, but I can hear a beautiful deep bass that is extremely quick, a lot of detail, a lot of clarity, excellent bass. I'm actually very excited about the bass of the Air A3 SA. You get a very natural toned mid-range, the just such a natural tonality, very detailed, also very good instrument separation and very good revealing abilities. Not a very good soundstage, it is pretty keyhole, it is small, it is intimate, it is right there with you, but you get good instrument separation, so you can hear a ton of stuff that you normally wouldn't, even when comparing them to pretty expensive EMs. So even up to 1000 euros in terms of pricing, or $1000, they still can hold their ground in terms of detail and resolution. The treble is a bit disappointing. It is very smooth, very good for long hours of listening, but not very good in terms of energy and engagement. So they are pretty engaging in bass if you don't mind the very flat amount. It is extremely flat. There is no extra bass, no extra warmth. It is a very flat type of bass. But the actual mid-range is beautiful. The bass detail, bass resolution is beautiful. You'd never hear a bass distortion with them. And even turning them extremely loud results in a very clear, clean and precise sound. And that actually surprised me a lot, coming from a ton of other EMs. I don't even want to talk about it. It's so much that I've reviewed. I know how so many things sound like. And those ones at $100, at least at the moment of making this video review, they are on sale. They are totally worth their money if you are looking for a flat sound. A flat sound typically means a very flat bass, very flat mid-range, and pretty flat treble. Flat does not mean neutral though, so they are not very neutral. They don't have that colder, brighter type of signature in the treble. They are very smooth, very relaxing, and very easy to listen to for many hours in a row. And that works pretty well, actually. I like their sound. If I was to call any issues with them, they actually are not very fatiguing. The older series were quite fatiguing, especially in the mid-range. They were grainy, they were a bit too detailed, and that led to a ton of fatigue. So the Air A3 SA is not fatiguing at all, but they can be a bit unengaging, and they can be a bit too flat and too boring sounding, especially in the treble. If you are used to brighter type of sounds, for example, I'm reviewing them quite soon after reviewing the Unique Melody 3DT. And the Etymotic Air A3 SA actually sounds a bit too flat and a bit too relaxed. The whole mid-range, the whole relaxed treble part is a bit too much for me, so I'm not having enough engagement from them. On the other hand, comparing them to something like the KZ Monitor series, those ones are way more detailed, way more natural in the mid-range. And while the treble is nowhere near as sparkly as a KZ EM is in general, like KZ AS10, AZ10, B, A10. I reviewed all of them, just trust me, I know how the KZ house sound is like. KZ's house sound is a very aggressive V-shaped sound. There are flavors of it, but they are all V-shaped. I have not heard a KZ EM that is not V-shaped in some way. And the Etymotic is quite the opposite. They have the mid-range forward, and the bass and the treble are behind the mid-range. That works extremely well if you are going to produce music, to master, to mix, to listen to music. If you are going to be on a stage performing, you can hear yourself very clearly, especially for monitoring voices, for monitoring guitars, for monitoring any type of instrument. They are not exactly the best for monitoring drums though, because they have such little energy in the sub lows and such little energy in the treble, so you don't really hear the cymbal crashes. There are better options for monitoring drums, but they are quite excellent for monitoring voices, for monitoring most instruments, and I actually like them quite a lot. To give you some perspective, while writing the review, I was listening to the Unique Melody Mest 2 because it just arrived and I was curious about them. And then I realized that I have to write the review about the Etymotic RA3SA because I was quite behind my own schedule. I'm always behind my own schedule and I apologize to you, my viewers, I apologize to everyone. I am absolutely always a bit behind schedule with everything. I'm not someone who is in time. And I don't know how other reviewers do it. I don't know how they get to be in time. I'm just not someone who is right on time. Like, this is who I am. I hope you can bear with me. I hope that is acceptable to you. It takes me some time to get my thoughts in order and to be able to give you my impressions and to be a bit precise with my impressions. If I make the review right after receiving something, I'm going to have a very undetailed opinion, very bland opinion, because I would not have listened enough to that thing. And that is why I avoid reviewing something as soon as it comes. I avoid that as much as I can. I want to have some time with something. I want to see how it works in time. I want to see how it holds up to usage. And this is why my reviews are actually a few months later, sometimes at least a few weeks later than most reviewers, especially than the big ones. We tend to receive the product at the same time, but I just prefer to take a bit more time to get used to the product. I also have been doing this for a while, so I have quite a backlog to go through. So yeah, it is like a waterfall effect, really. I'm just apologizing that I am not quite as able to do it that fast. My experience with the Etymotic RA3SA was like this. I was listening to the Unique Melody Mest 2 and I thought to myself that I need to review the Etymotic RA3SA. I already had some time with them and I switched straight from the Mest 2 to the Etymotic RA3SA. At first, I was afraid that I was going to be quite disappointed and I was going to be quite negativistic. But really, I wasn't. The sound was not that bad. It was a downgrade in every way because the Mest 2 is $2,500 EM. I need to check the price on that one. I'm not quite sure what the price is, but the Mest 2 is way more expensive than the RA3SA. While listening to the RA3SA, after getting used to the sound, I was enjoying myself. I was enjoying the clear but very fast-paced bass. I have been enjoying their mid-range quite a lot, and while the treble did not impress me very much because they are pretty smooth on the treble and I'm used to much more energetic trebles, I was impressed in general by their overall resolution, clarity, precision. I would happily use those to mix and master my own videos, to mix and master music, to perform live. I would just not use them for listening quite as much because I prefer having something a bit more exciting to listen. I prefer a bit more treble, but Etymotic were never about treble. And although their drivers are some of the fastest, even them have accepted that you may need a few more drivers. And right now they are making series with multiple drivers inside their EMs. Pretty good stuff and pretty exciting. I can't wait to hear their more interesting stuff. I hope that you would like to support Audiophile Heaven. Speaking of advertising, of course, I hope that you could donate if you have a dime to spare. I hope that you will leave a like on this video if you found it to be enjoyable. I hope you will also subscribe to Audiophile Heaven. And more than anything, I really hope that you have the loveliest of weeks in there and that this video has been helpful to you. I thank you for watching and we'll see each other really, really soon. Bye bye.